A new lawsuit has been filed in connection with that April shooting that killed Greenland's police chief and injured four other officers. Those four men are now suing the mother of the accused shooter, Cullen Mutrie, who investigators say killed himself. Jennifer Gannon is live tonight with our top story.
Well, the lawsuit claims that Beverly Mutrie knew about criminal activity at the home where the shooting took place, but her attorney says there's no evidence to support that.
The officers were not named in the lawsuit, but the lawsuit states that the plaintiffs were shot and wounded by Cullen Mutrie. The four wounded officers were 33-year-old Scott Cookish, 34-year-old Jeremiah Murphy, 32-year-old Gregory Turner, and 31-year-old Eric Kohlberg. The lawsuit claims that the suspected shooter, Cullen Mutrie's mother, Beverly Mutrie, indirectly facilitated the criminal activity as the owner of the property. The officers were at the home on April 12th to serve a warrant. The lawsuit claims the plaintiffs were caused to suffer severe bodily and other injuries and damages as allowed by law as a result of being shot at and wounded by Cullen Mutrie, relating to Cullen Mutrie's engaging in the criminal activities which Beverly Mutrie wantonly and recklessly allowed to occur. The attorney representing Beverly Mutrie filed a motion to dismiss the case, arguing that there are no facts to support the claims and that she simply owned the property. He argued that Mrs. Mutrie had no knowledge of any criminal activity or any charges other than those that have been a matter of public record. WMUR legal analyst Mark Stevens says it will all come down to what Beverly Mutrie knew about the activity at the home.
If it's, you know, open and notorious that this is a drug house, then perhaps, she should have taken some steps to stop it. But it'll depend on the facts in the case and what the plaintiffs can prove. You know, can they prove that, you know, she was just turning a blind eye to this and knew about it? Or is it just, you know, suing whoever they can to try and get the house?
Now, we did reach out to attorneys on both sides of the case for a response tonight. They had no comment. Reporting live in the newsroom, Jennifer Gannon, WMUR News 9.